Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytubes.com. In this video, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate how to set up a 12-page brochure ready for print in Adobe InDesign. In the previous two videos, we set up a simple business card and letterhead. Now, these were all quite basic documents. Over the next three videos, we will be taking it to the next level and creating a brochure. By the end of this tutorial, you should have a good understanding of how InDesign works and how to set up a document with all the design elements ready to print. If you're new to InDesign, I'll be taking you through all the details and explaining all the things you need to be aware of when setting up a document like this. So before we get started, let's take a quick look at what we will be creating over the next three videos. So here is the brochure document open in InDesign. As I scroll down, we can see the design and composition of each spread. Currently, we are looking at this in preview mode. So if I press W, we will enter into normal mode. And here we can see all the guides and frame outlines. Now, if you're new to this course and wish to take a closer look at this document and get all the assets to follow along and build this brochure, you can get it all in the project folder. Remember, you will also have to install the fonts when you open this document that can also be found in the project folder. Download link is in the description. So previously in the course, I spoke about how I thought about and designed various compositions for the brochure. In this video, I will also be referring to my scamp design so you can get an understanding of my process. So here in InDesign, I have a 12-page document setup. Now, if I come over to the Pages panel, we can see a visual representation of my document structure. At the top, we have a single cover. Under this, we have all the various page spreads, and at the bottom, we have the back cover. Now, the front cover has been designed to work seamlessly with the back cover, and you may be wondering why the pages are set up like this. Well, all will be explained shortly. This is the standard booklet setup in Adobe InDesign. Now, above the visual guide, I have two master page setups, A and B, and we will be seeing how they are used later on. So I'll close this document, and now I'm going to set up a new document so we can start this from scratch. So I'm going to come up to File, New, and choose Document, and up will pop the New Document menu. So it's from here I'm going to specify the document size and properties. So first, I'll set the intent to print. I'll set the number of pages to 12. On this occasion, I'm going to leave facing pages checked, and this will be the ideal setup for a booklet which we intend to make. I'll start with page number 1 and come and set the document size. Now, again with the project folder open, navigate to the project assets folder. In that, I'm going to open the project brief folder and open the brief document. So in the brief, it specifies the dimensions of the brochure. We need to make the brochure the size of an A5 page portrait. So back in InDesign, I'll make sure the orientation is set to portrait, select paper size and choose A5 from the preset. Now, if for some reason you do not have this preset, enter in the values 148mm by 210mm. Now for columns, I'm going to set this to 2 and set the gutter size to 15mm. For the margins, I'm going to set each one to 17mm. Next, I'm going to toggle down bleed and slug. Now, back in the brief document, it states that bleed on all documents should be set to 3mm. So back in InDesign, I'll set the bleed to 3mm on the top, bottom, inside and outside. So once I'm happy with the settings, I'll click OK. Upon click, we now have the new document set up. Nice. So if I press W repeatedly on the keyboard, we can toggle between preview and normal mode. Now in normal mode, if you cannot see your guides, press Command colon. So in normal mode, the red line around the outside represents the bleed, and the magenta lines on the inside represent the inner margin and column guides. Later, when we come to export the document, you will see how the bleed comes into play. Now this document is going to be very complex. There are going to be lots of design objects, so to make it easy to manage, I'm going to structure the elements into layers. So over in the Layers panel, I'm going to define some layers and along the way, make sure all the elements are correctly placed into each. So currently we have layer 1. I'm going to double click on this and name it Base. At the bottom of the Layers panel, I'll click the little page icon to create a new layer and name it Textures. All my textures will be placed into this layer. At the bottom of the Layers panel, I'll click the little page icon again to create a new layer, and this time I'll name this Type, and I'll be putting all my type into this. I'll create a new layer, I'll call this Images, and I'll place all my images into this layer. Great, so now I'm in normal mode, the document is ready. We can start composing the design elements. But before that, if I come back to the brief document, it states on the print instructions that for the brochure, we will need to set this up to be printed using CMYK colors. Okay, so before we start to build the design elements, we need to make sure we have the correct CMYK colors ready to apply to the design. Currently, in the swatches panel, we have a bunch of default colors. Now, in the previous two episodes, we used Pantone colors. Now, this was because there were only four colors used in the entire composition. In this brochure, we will be using photos, so for this reason, we need to use CMYK. So with the project folder open, navigate to the Project Assets folder. In that, open the Branding folder and open the branding document. So here we are now in Adobe Illustrator, where the branding document was originally composed. Here we can clearly see the CMYK color references. So now I'm going to take the CMYK references and get the colors into InDesign. So to make it real easy, I'm going to select the type that states the CMYK references. I'll copy, come into InDesign, and just paste. So at a glance, I can see the CMYK references. Great. So in InDesign, I'll come over to the swatches panel. If you cannot see yours, you can come up to Window, scroll down and activate your swatches panel there. So I'll come up to the top right with the little menu icon. From the menu, I'll select New Color Swatch and up will pop the menu. So from the color mode, I'll click and make sure this is set to CMYK. So with that set, I'll now type in the values for the CMYK to get my first color. So I'll start with the base gray, 84 for cyan, 67 for magenta, 56 for yellow, and 68 for K. So when I can see I have the correct color, I'll uncheck the name with color value box. I'll name this base gray and click the add button on the right. And just like that, we have a new CMYK swatch in the swatches panel ready to use. Now we still have the new color swatch menu box open. So now I'm quickly going to go through and create the other three CMYK swatches, typing in the values, naming them and adding them to the swatches panel, like so. Soon, I'll have all four color swatches in my panel ready to use. So to tidy up my swatches panel, I will select the top swatch I will not use. With Shift held down, I'll select the last swatch just above the first swatch I created and click the delete icon at the bottom of the panel. So now all we have are the colors we want to use. Perfect. So with the selection tool, I'll select the reference in the canvas area and press backspace to remove this. So now we are ready to start with the design. So I'm going to start with the base of the brochure. If we look at the finished design, the background on all the pages is the dark grey colour. So to make this real easy in my new document, I'm going to come over to the master pages in the pages panel. So looking at the pages panel, we can see a visual representation of the document setup here. And just above this is the master pages. So I'll come up to a master page and double click on this. Upon click, we will see the master page, in this case, the master spread. So master pages allow us to place design elements into them in a single instance. We can then apply master pages to multiple pages inside the main document. This can save us time duplicating elements and updating elements. Also, this can prove helpful when naming pages. More on that later. Master pages are vital for an efficient and streamlined workflow, one of the main benefits of using InDesign for print. Okay, so here I'm going to come over to the menu and select the rectangle tool. Now, I'm about to create some background color, so I'll come over to the layers panel and make sure I have the base layer selected. Then I'll draw a box to cover the canvas area of the entire spread. Notice how I start from the edge of the bleed in the top left and down to the bleed in the bottom right. So with the new box, I'm going to come over to the menu at the bottom and make sure the fill color is set to the gray base CMYK swatch by selecting it in the swatches panel. So the last thing I'm going to do is select the box. Now notice how we can see the square points around the bounding box. This is indicating the center and middle points. So I'll press Command R to activate rulers around the canvas area, and I'll drag out a guide from the top. I'll drag it down in the pasteboard area like so. I'll drag it down to meet the middle point and release. This will apply a guide across both pages, and this will define the middle line. Next, I'll click and drag a guide from the left margin, but this time place it in the middle of the gutter on the left page. Then I'll drag out another ruler and place it in the middle of the gutter on the right page. So that defines the center and middle guides. Nice. So once I'm happy with the box and the guides, I'll come into the page display in the pages panel and double click on page 1. This will just exit master pages. Notice now how the background is applied to all my pages, and we can see the guides on each spread. If we look closely in the page display in the pages panel and look at the pages, we can see that on the display, we have the letter A assigned to each page. This means that the master page A is applied. So now we have the background set up in each page. We don't have to worry about this later. Now, what about page numbers? Let me show you a great way to set up page numbers in InDesign. So for this, I'm going to come back into the master page we just set up by double-clicking into the master page icon in the pages panel. So in the layers panel, I'll select type. With the type tool, I'll come into the canvas area and draw a type box like so. Next, I'll come up to type, scroll down to insert special character, come across to markers and select current page number. Upon click, we will notice a little A character appear in the box. So I'll select this A character in the type frame and change the color to Synergy Purple. Up in the control panel, I'll click into the font and type open and select Open Sans Bold, and I'll change the font size to 9. Remember, you will need to install the fonts if you want to follow along with this. So I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type, select the box and move it down to the bottom left. I'll zoom in and just click the bounding box and make it small like so, and reposition. With the box selected, I'll copy, press and hold spacebar, and drag to pan across my spread into the next page. I'll paste and position a copy in the bottom right corner. Now, in this instance, I'll double click into the type box and click the alignment to the right up in the control panel. I'll choose the selection tool to deselect the type. I'll zoom out. I'll select both boxes and click the align vertical button in the control panel. Perfect. Now you may be wondering why it says A in the box. Well, this is because we are currently on the master A page. So if I exit the master page by double clicking on one of the spreads in the pages panel, we can see that the page numbers now apply accurately to each spread. That's pretty awesome. So no need to manually put page numbers into InDesign. So that's how you can set up a booklet document in Adobe InDesign. Once you're happy, press Command S to save. Navigate to the My Project folder in the Project folder and save the document in the WorkDocs folder as Brochure. So now we have set up the document, it's time to start adding the design elements. In the next video, I'm going to bring in all the images and textures and demonstrate how we can manage this. See you in the next video.